Hello, Austin Gardeners. We're going to talk about the May garden. A lot is going on. Hopefully you have some plants in the ground. We're getting them established. And in May, we want to keep to the basics in that we can add compost. We definitely want to mulch. We want to try to conserve the moisture in our soil. So we're going to start maybe watering a little differently. We want to be sure that we have water wells around the stems of our plants so we can trap water and rain when it comes. And as the sun gets higher in the sky, we want to maybe change the time that we're watering and also the duration that we're watering. So some of our vegetables and summer flowers have pretty thin leaves that can get scorched by water. So City of Austin recommends watering before 10 a.m. or after 6 p.m. As our plants are establishing and getting ready for our summer heat, we want to train those roots to really go down and seek water deeper in the soil. So fewer but longer soaking water. Soaking with seaweed is great for training roots and also for providing a lot of plant hormones and trace minerals for your plants. Okay, now let's talk about some things that we can predict that we might be seeing in our May garden. We'll hopefully be seeing some beneficial insects, and we may be seeing some pests. One interesting tip that I thought I would share with you and goes with the organic technique of planting all things together, vegetables, herbs, and flowers, is I saw a gardener who suggested adding a few drops of mint extract to a spray bottle of water and to spray your cucumber plants with that because it helps to thwart the scent as those cucumber beetles fly around. And so as you're maybe seeing holes in your garden, if they're by some of your vegetables, maybe grab a companion planting chart. This is one of my favorites because it has pictures. And maybe see if there's a companion that's an herb to your vegetable. Something like mint, you may want to keep in a pot. You can plant that pot in the ground right by your vegetable so that mint doesn't spread. Mint is notorious for spreading. Just in time. Cue the caterpillar. So, insects in our garden. We need them, you know, pollinators, and there's beneficials and there's pests. So we really like apps like iNaturalist for a quick identification. And then a local source like our Texas Bug Book. And the City of Austin has great leaflets that you can find at many garden stores. This one is on beneficial insects. Really like it because there are pictures talking about our good guys, and super important, it shows a picture of their larva. Look how different the larva of the ladybug is. Looks nothing like a ladybug. So important, you know, when we see eggs and small bugs, maybe they're good guys. There's also one like this on pests. Turning to one of my favorite local resources, this is Tricia Shirey's book on vegetable gardening in the Southwest. And one thing that she recommends is seaweed. You know, we love seaweed for all things. Really good for your lawn, for our vegetables. It helps with heat stress. It helps with setting roots. So foliar feeding with seaweed doesn't have to be fancy. I think I got this bottle at the dollar store. Foliar feeds up to once a week can leave a residue just like insecticidal soap or garlic sprays. It'll leave a residue on your leaves that will just make them not taste good to pests. Pests will generally attack stressed plants So you may look for things that are starting to die out. Some things are bolting, like in the case of chamomile. That's great because we pick those flowers for tea. Other things, they're going to start really being stressed, and pests will probably show up. The early May garden may not be the showiest spot. As our plants establish, you know, we may have just a low growing, mostly green garden. You can interplant purple varieties, purple basil, purple beans, to have some visual interest and some different flavors in there. But know that the blooms are coming, right? Our mantra in organics, feed the soil, the plants know what to do. Lots of pretty blooms are coming. Look at our zucchinis. We're gonna have those beautiful blooms on the okra that's in the hibiscus family. Our summer flowers, now is a good time to plant your summer flowers. Get them established before the heat, and you'll have cut flowers at the same time as you go out to harvest your vegetables. Keep talking to your neighbors. Keep supporting our local nurseries. Stay a part of our conversation. Let us know what's going on in your gardens on our Facebook page, on Instagram, and join us for our monthly meetings it's a free Zoom link on our website, austinorganicgardeners.org.